now to one event that could mean tens of millions for our area. Today, the 2010 Viking Classic kicks off for the first time since torrential rains washed out the million-dollar event last year. 16 WAPT's Scott Simmons is live with how this year's forecast could prevent a major loss. And Scott's pretty nice out there.
Exactly, Megan. In fact, the dramatic difference this year is the weather. It's dramatically better. But, you know, last year's washout cast some doubts on how successful this year's event might be. But take a look over my shoulder and you get an idea of the forecast so far. The weather looks great. The course looks wonderful. And Emeril Lagasse is coming to town. Kaylee Barrett is just one of over 1,000 volunteers who is glad to be in place in the sun as opposed to rain like last year. She says there's a volunteer vibe this year.
Yes, it is. We have over 30 volunteers today, and we'll have over 50 Wednesday.
Just in this area?
Just in this area.
Last year's PGA event was rained out, and it dampened an event that touts a $20 million a year economic impact.
Well, the obvious is, you know, we went from the worst possible weather to the very best.
Tournament director Randy Watkins says a lot of things are different this year. He says they were able to weather last year's planning because of money set aside literally for that rainy day.
You know, all businesses have a reserve, you know, in case there's an emergency or there's a problem. And this tournament has done that. Mm-hmm. And you know, that was what it was for. And the tournament's been through so many things over the years. You know, there's been tornadoes and there's been other issues in its history.
The Classic is more than a golf tournament. It is also a fundraiser for local charities like Blair Batson Hospital. Event organizers say that forecast is better this year.
Since our inception in 94, we've given just under $6 million to charities around the state of Mississippi, including last year when we were able to give just under $570,000.
Viking's long-term role in this event is in question because of this economy, but not this year. In fact, the Mississippi company has agreed to sponsor next year's tournament in 2011.
There are no easy decisions today in today's economy, but you know, we forged forward, and we absolutely wanted to, you know, have another year of golf after what happened last year, which was difficult for everybody, not only for the PGA and Viking, but for our volunteers and our co-sponsors and so forth.
Viking is vital, not only because of the enormous corporate support here, but also because of the chefs it brings to town. Emeril Lagasse, of course, the headliner chef this year with cooking demonstrations this Thursday and Friday over in the Viking tent, and it is expected to be standing room only. Remember, there is no profit margin for this event. After paying the bills and the golfers who play here, all the other money goes to charities. Live at Annandale, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News. Megan, back to you.
All right, thank you, Scott. And we do want to see your pictures from the Viking Classic if you're headed out to Annandale. Go to our website, WAPT.com, and upload them in our You Local section. If you do that, you may see them right here on our air. Now to our Commitment 2010 coverage, where we give you complete coverage of the upcoming November elections. Today, Governor Barbour hit the campaign trail. Barbour is in demand because he's chairman of the Republican Governors Association. He campaigned for Republican John Stephen, who's running for governor in New Hampshire, and Paul